The Barbican trial was an investigator-initiated randomized phase II trial that investigated a combination of chemotherapy and immune therapy with and without the addition of an AKT inhibitor. The addition of the AKT inhibitor Ipatasertib was based on promising data we saw in a metastatic setting where we had high response rates in a first-line trial investigating the combination of paclitaxel, Ipatasertib, the AKT inhibitor, and Atezolizumab as a checkpoint inhibitor. We therefore moved the same regimen into an early disease setting where we wanted to evaluate the clinical and biological effects of adding the AKT inhibitor to chemotherapy and immune therapy. Patients in this trial were again stage 2, stage 3, early triple-negative breast cancer, were randomized 1-to-1 to a run-in with atezolizumab or atezolizumab and ipatasertib, followed by a biopsy after 2 weeks, then 12 weeks of weekly paclitaxel therapy in combination with atezolizumab, again with or without ipatasertib, and then followed by another biopsy, and then 4 cycles of AC, moving on to surgery. The study had 2 primary endpoints. At this point in time, we reported the first primary endpoint, which is pathological rates. A second primary endpoint will be change in biomarker levels, in particular in Granzyme B, positive CD8 positive T cells after the induction with atezolizumab or atezolizumab ipatasertib, which we present at a subsequent meeting. The study was well balanced in terms of tumor size, stage, and PD-L1 status. What we saw, it has pathological complete responses, was there was no difference between the two arms. We saw 48.5% PAF-CR rate with atezolizumab and neoadjuvant chemotherapy, and 49.3% with atezolizumab chemotherapy and ipatasertib. In a planned analysis looking at the PAF-CR rates by PD-L1 status, it seemed that patients with PD-L1 positive tumors had a slightly higher PAF-CR rate with atezolizumab and chemotherapy without the AKT inhibitors, whereas in patients with PD-L1 negative tumors, we saw 25% PAF-CR rate in with atezolizumab and chemotherapy and 32.4% PAF-CR rate with the triplet combination. One of the challenges in this study was very clearly toxicity. We saw substantially more toxicity with the addition of the AKT inhibitor to chemotherapy and immune therapy, and in particular saw an increase in rash that diarrhea that frequently led to discontinuation of the therapy. As a result, the dose intensity in the triplet arm was relatively low, which may have affected the results we saw here. So in summary, this is a randomized phase II trial evaluating a doublet chemotherapy and immune therapy and a triplet chemotherapy, immune therapy, and an AKT inhibitor with no difference in PAF-CR rates observed, possible difference in subgroup, which will be further investigated. An increase in toxicity seen, the 73% of patients having grade 3 or higher AE rates with the triplet compared to 40% with the doublet. That led to a decrease in the dose intensity with ipatasertib. And at this point in time, we are not recommending further investigation of this regimen in this context. But we will, of course, follow our patients. As we've learned from KEYNOTE-522, there is still a possibility that we see a long-term benefit in terms of event-free survival, and we will present this in the future.